Dr. Scott Gottlieb is a healthcare venture capitalist and member of Pfizer's board. He was the FDA commissioner from 2017 until April of 2019. As the COVID-19 pandemic unfolded, he was in regular contact with all key members of Congress and the Trump administration.
His new book is called Uncontrolled Spread, Why COVID-19 Crushed Us and How We Can Defeat the New Pandemic. It provides an inside account of how level after level of American government crumbled as that crisis advanced. And he joins us live. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks a lot.
So talk about in the early 2000s, I didn't realize that you helped develop this pandemic influenza plan based on the flu, but was it something that could be applied to basically any pandemic? And what went wrong, or did they just not update it?
No, it wasn't generally applicable, and that's the problem. Back in the Bush administration in 2005, when I was at FDA's deputy commissioner, we undertook a pretty broad process to try to prepare for a pandemic. But the pandemic that we were worried about was flu, particularly a strain of bird flu called H5N1 that was circulating at the time. We put in place a lot of preparations, but those weren't generally applicable. So when the coronavirus struck us, first of all, a lot of the preparations we had made had atrophied. But even if they had not, even if we had continued those investments, the planning that we had undertaken wasn't broad enough to cover the kinds of contingencies that we faced in the setting of this crisis. For example, We never really planned for the ability to mass deploy diagnostic testing, because in the setting of a flu pandemic, diagnostic tests wouldn't be as important because of the short incubation period of flu and the fact that people aren't contagious until they're symptomatic. But with a coronavirus, with a very long incubation period and the fact that people spread the virus when they weren't symptomatic, diagnostic testing became very important, but it was never part of our planning.
Early on in the pandemic last year, there was so much chaotic information. We were getting information from the CDC and the FDA, and a lot of times it didn't line up with each other. Why couldn't these government agencies come together and give a unified message?
It wasn't just that we didn't have a unified message. I don't think we did a good job of gathering information, doing the real-time analytical work to inform current policy decisions. So, for example, it took us far too long to figure out that this virus wasn't spreading through contaminated surfaces. How long did we spend wiping down our groceries thinking that this was spreading through contaminated surfaces? It took us far too long to figure out that this was spreading through aerosols and not just droplets, so that in confined spaces it could travel long distances. The recommendation that people stay 6 feet apart wasn't well informed. We ultimately revised it to 3 feet in the setting of people who are wearing masks so that schools could open. But the initial proposal was for 10 feet. So there just wasn't good information being gathered and good analytical work being done. And one of the places where I place some of the blame in the book, or a lot of the blame, is with the CDC. I think the CDC, while an exceptional organization in many regards, isn't prepared to handle a crisis of this magnitude. As far as the conflicting advice from different agencies, we saw that most clearly with respect to the vaccines, where CDC and FDA seemed to be issuing different advice based on the same scientific information. But that's a feature of the process. The process is designed to allow FDA and CDC to separately evaluate things like who should receive a vaccine and render different kinds of advice to the public based on the same underlying scientific information. So it creates a perception that there's a conflict. There's really not. What we want is the process to be very slow, very deliberative, very careful. But in a setting of a crisis, you want the agencies to be unified and you want the process to be more fluid. So we probably should have created a different kind of scheme for coming up with recommendations, for example, about who should get booster shots, rather than try to leave that to the same old process that we use in normal times. We basically used a peacetime process in a wartime setting, and it wasn't well suited.
So do you think going forward, are we going to see COVID-19 something we get a shot for every year? And also going forward, are we prepared for the next pandemic?
Yeah, look, I think that this, for a period of time, is probably going to be an annualized vaccination, at least for a component of the population. And as you know, I'm on the board of Pfizer. I look at the data very closely. I do think for a portion of the more vulnerable population, this will be an annualized vaccine, at least for a period of time until we understand what the post-pandemic phase looks like. And the other thing is we may switch over the vaccines eventually to a different kind of vaccine using a Delta backbone. So we may eventually have a Delta backbone vaccine if, in fact, the predominant strain of coronavirus that circulates remains Delta and mutations that occur in the future happen within that Delta lineage, which a lot of people think is likely to be the case. Are we better prepared? I think we're better prepared insofar as we understand what our weaknesses are and the vulnerabilities and the lack of capabilities. But I don't think we've done a lot to better prepare the nation if a pandemic struck again. There's just a better awareness of where the gaps are. I was hoping this book would come out and help would be part of that discussion. I thought Congress would already be taking this up in earnest. That discussion seems to be delayed. I think that eventually Congress and others will start to think about how we better prepare the nation through shoring up some of this infrastructure and agencies like the CDC. But we really haven't begun that process yet.
All right. For more information, you can check out uncontrolledspread.com and follow Scott Gottlieb on Twitter. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks a lot.